So Kyndra and I first met at the University of Waterloo, where we both majored in French. The first real memory I have of Kyndra was during a fairly large class that she came bustling into right before the lecture began. I recognized her from some of my other classes, and I was really impressed by all the snacks she had nicely packed and was pulling out of her bag. It looked like she might have come right from the gym. She looked kind of red, and she had gym shoes strapped to her bag, and it seemed like she was pretty hungry based on the quality of snacks she was pulling out from these tiny snack-sized containers. So we started talking, and I thought that this is a friend that I would like to have. She was so energetic, and she was pumped about our boring psychology class. Seemed like she just came from a great workout. I needed that type of motivation. Kyndra is a very giving person, and people are naturally drawn to her because of it.
Asking Kyndra why, like, why Steve? I don't understand. Why do you like him? I don't know, like, what's going on? And she was like, and she just turned to me, looked me straight in the face. I've never seen someone look so serious in my life. And she goes, I just like him.
Anyone here like me who has been lucky enough to spend time in their company knows what a great couple they are together. Perfectly complementing each other, I think we can all agree that Kyndra looks like one in a million today. I first met Steve playing for our high school soccer team, and I think that's the main reason we're such good friends to this day. The guy just can't get enough of it. Honestly, up until this year, we would be out probably 5 times a week playing soccer, practicing, whatever. And it's exhausting to look back and think about it. The guy just runs forever.
Steve is energetic and full of life. He's always had a smile plastered on his face and can turn anything into a joke, as I think we saw in the vows today. He is always so welcoming when I come for a visit as the subpar former roommate. One time we even did a puzzle together for hours while Kyndra napped.
One of my favorite things about Steve is how nerdy he is. Anyone who knows anything about him will agree he's got to be one of the nerdiest people you know. All the way from video games, TV shows, to movies. It may sound like I'm saying that in a bad way, but I'm not. It's actually quite the opposite. It's so nice knowing that anytime something new comes out, I have somebody to talk to it about.
On our first date all those years ago, I felt like I found my best friend. Over the next few months, we did everything together, and I realized, wow, this is an amazing woman. For 9 years, you have been a huge part of my life and my passion. My number one soccer fan, and I know I'll always be able to depend on your support in the future. You are the most beautiful, smart, and generous person I've ever known, and I promise always to respect you and love you with kindness, unselfishness, and trust. I will work by your side to create a wonderful life together. Kyndra, you are the Leia to my Han Solo, and I vow to love you as you deserve to be loved, with admiration, adoration, passion, respect, and to treat you like the woman that you are, even when you're scarfing down toast. I vow to remain loyal to you physically and emotionally, and I vow to be open-minded to getting one more cat. I look forward to growing old with you and playing euchre and skippo on the porch. Kyndra, you're not only beautiful, but also kind, and that is not something that I take lightly. I love you more than anything, and I can't wait for our next adventures together.
I vow to always laugh with you like friends, to forgive you as family, to support you the way you have always supported me, and to love you even more than I do our cats, which you know is a ridiculous amount. I will dream with you, celebrate with you, and walk beside you through whatever our lives may bring. I promise to be faithful and supportive and to always make our family's love and happiness my priority. I promise to let you watch Star Wars as many times as you want. However, I can't promise that I will pretend to like it. I promise to try to be on time. That one's not a joke. And I promise to be your biggest cheerleader, both on the soccer field and in life. I'll be yours in sickness and in health, in failure and in triumph. I truly feel so lucky to be the woman who gets to marry you. I'm grateful for you each and every day, and my heart is so completely happy when I'm with you. You're the love of my life, and you make me happier than I could have ever imagined. I feel more loved by you than I ever thought possible. You're my person. Thank you for being you. I love you.
And now, by virtue of the powers vested in me by the Marriage Act of the Province of Ontario, I, dear, do hereby pronounce you husband and wife, and best friends for life. You may symbolically seal your union with a kiss. First time as husband and wife, Mr. Stephen and Mrs. Kyndra.
Have a relationship to be admired and celebrated, a relationship of mutual support and understanding, a relationship of unconditional love, a relationship of fun and zest for life, a relationship of cats and Star Wars.